Hello everyone and welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to film a draw with me video. I've not really done anything like this before, but I've recently filmed some tutorials and I've had a few of my artist friends from Instagram say they've just put them on in the background as like a little draw with me kind of thing, so that they don't feel as alone when they're drawing. So I thought it might be nice to just film a drawing that I'm doing, and yeah, if you're drawing or painting or anything at all, you can draw with me. So this is a Hare that I'm currently drawing, and it's quite big. It's like the full size of a Fabriano hot press watercolour. Piece of paper. It's like 22 inch times 30 or something. It's quite big anyway, and it's taken me quite a while, but I'm just trying to fit a few hours in here and there wherever possible. So I've just been working on this front foot and trying to build up the layers and get the right tonal values. It's just one of them, you never know when to stop with the layers. So, see how far I get. The coloured pencils that I'm using are Faber-Castell polychromos mostly, and sometimes I do use Luminance or Pablo's too, so just building up the brown tones at the minute. But yeah, if you're watching just as like a draw with me for a bit of company while you're working, let me know what you're doing, what you're working on. Don't know if I'm going to be talking that much throughout this because I struggle to talk and concentrate at the same time, so yeah. I'm just using burnt umber to build up some darker brown tones. I think this hair, I'm planning on making some limited edition prints and using it for like greeting cards, designs, and anything that it looks good on, basically. And hopefully, fingers crossed, I'll be able to sell the original too. So somebody can put it up in the house or wherever. But yeah, a lot of hours have gone into this so far. Feels longer than it probably is because I've only been doing bits here and there, but I think it's good to work on a few different things at once and like switch it up after a few hours anyway. I'm thinking if these draw with me's are like well received, I might try to start uploading twice a week and do like one tutorial and one draw with me, and then I can just film whatever I'm working on at the minute, whether it's like a commission or original piece. And even though it's not like I'm not really showing you much of how to draw, you can sort of pick up techniques, I suppose. really hot again today. It's like summer has come back. It's lovely. So just in case anyone's wondering, I used ivory as a base, followed by bistre for mapping out the fur details, and then in some places I've used brown ochre 10% from the luminance, just like mostly around the bottom, and I've also used a bit of dark sepia as well. Close the window again. Next door's dog is quite old, so it does bark quite a lot, bless it. I really like the composition of this hair piece, how it's like leaping mid-air. So I need like a good name for it once I've finished. I didn't know whether to like be very literal with the names of my original wildlife pieces, like Hare Study or whatever, or whether to call them more like arty names. Like, I don't know, I can't think of any examples, but I think it's nice to have like a proper name for them. I've got like so many originals that I've just never done anything with because I don't know, I think it's a confidence thing. I'm like, oh, I don't know, it's not good enough to make prints or not good enough to put on anything. But I think I need to just get on with it and make some prints. I think everybody has self-doubt though, don't they? I think it's also good that like, even if you're a commission artist and you do a lot of commissions of people's pets or anything that they've commissioned you to draw, I think it is always good to do a bit of something for yourself, something that like you've picked and you're just gonna do in your spare time or at the end of the day when you've got a spare hour. No, I think it just keeps you quite motivated and changes it up a bit. nearly at 5,000 followers now on Instagram, which is amazing. Can't believe it. It's weird, like sometimes my Instagram will be like, I won't have any change or growth on it for like a month or more. And then suddenly everything comes at once. I don't know why that happens. But does that happen to anyone else? But yeah, that's exciting. It's nice that so many people want to follow my artwork. And I follow so many other amazing artists as well. I love the art community, it's such like a nice positive place on the whole. Yeah, if you don't follow me on Instagram, then I'll leave my link down below, because I do share more on Instagram than I share on here. I post like more frequently and stuff, so yeah, love it if you came and followed. My SD card just was full and needed formatting, so I don't remember if I was saying anything or not. But yeah, I think I'm not far off with this foot as it is, so I might move on to this bit here, which is quite hard to draw because I'll show you the picture. The fur is like all over the place, but I'll just take my time, it'll be fine. My eyes get so confused when I'm drawing this bit. Just been trying to make it look like all the little hairs cross over and stuff, but I don't know, I'm not fully happy with it, but I never am, so that's irrelevant anyway.
I think I just need a bit more dark sepia in places.
I'm just hoping that I'm gonna like it when I've done all of it. This is so confusing. Trying to make it look fluffy and not too harsh, but I feel like I've started it off quite harsh, so now I'm gonna have to like carry on with the same style. Right, I think I need some luminance.
Pinky at the bottom.
So I might add some beige red.
I like the tone that that's adding.
Most of the time I have no idea what I'm doing, I just make it up as I go along and hope for the best. going to use burnt umber now and start adding
a bit more detail. This makes like the biggest difference, I think. Needs more of like a red orange tone.
That is too orange.
A bit of that through here. That's a nice tone. This is brownish orange Pablo's.
I think I'll use burnt ochre
just to bring out more of an orange tone. Just gonna really lightly glaze it over.
looking
a bit more how I want it. Burnt ochre, a really hard colour to work with. It's not very pigmented, I don't think.
Doesn't go on very easily. You either have to like press really hard or go over it like loads. I'm having to stand up for parts of this. I have to like keep standing back and proper looking at it
from a distance.
Such a slow process, but
I think it'll hopefully come together soon. Just think I need a bit of more of a pinky tone through this bit as well.
My battery just died. Carry on from here. Yeah, hope you enjoying this video. If you're also working on something, whether it's creative or not. To be fair, I enjoy watching other people draw while I'm drawing. Right, I think I'll leave it at that for today, just because my office is getting so hot without the window open, and it's really loud if I open it, so yeah, I think, it's looking good. Very self-critical, and I will never be fully happy with it, but that's just me. But yeah, I hope you've enjoyed this draw with me. And please give this video a like and subscribe if you did. And there'll be more where that came from, because I'm literally always drawing. So yeah, thank you very much for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye.